Yo guys, what's going on?
And I just finished a juicy chest workout. And I was thinking about it whilst I was working out. And being born with pec excavatum, which is the body deformity that I was born with, if you've been subscribed to me for a while, you should know, where basically my chest wall caved in. I literally had like no chest muscle, no muscular development in my chest whatsoever. And it was by far my worst body part. Like literally it was deformed and there was just no muscle. Like look at this photo here, right? And I remember I used to cover my chest. Like I was so self-conscious of my chest. And now I've probably built it into my best physique. People compliment me on my chest all the time. It pops from my body and I'm so proud and happy with the way my chest looks. Like just look at my transformation here that I'm putting up here. And now I feel like if there's one thing that I'm an expert in, it's improving the look of your chest. Because being born with pec excavatum, I was on a hellbent mission from when I joined the gym at 16 to transform my chest. So I studied everything to do with the chest. I've trialed like every single exercise. So I know a bit to do with growing your chest. And I think that's pretty evident when you just look at my transformation. So what I thought I would do is cut the crap. This isn't going to be a vlog. This is just going to straight down. We're going to get to the point on how to grow your chest. So I just filmed some exercise tutorials for my pectus transformation project, which has either launched or it's about to launch. And basically within that project you have access to over 80 exercise tutorials where I run through each exercise. And basically I just finished filming a whole bunch of chest exercises. And so what I thought I'd do is make this video where I run through my tips for growing your chest. So that's what I'm going to do in this video.
First things first, progressive overload on compound movements is a staple for building muscle in basically any exercise. Well, progressive overload is, because basically in order for an adaptation such as muscular growth or strength, anything to occur, you have to progressively increase the tension on it. You have to force the muscle to change. If the muscle just is getting the same stimulus again and again, the same amount of weight, the same amount of reps, nothing's going to change because it doesn't need to change. The body, the muscles, they like homeostasis. They like to stay the same. It's comfortable and it's easy. Why the hell would your body make more muscle cells unless it's getting forced to? So you have to force it to do that by progressively getting stronger, progressively overloading. So like you see me doing exercise here, like the bench press, the incline press, the decline press, compound movements are the best things to really emphasize progressive overload on, because you can lift a heavier weight. So therefore, for example, if you're lifting like 60 kilos or 100 kilos, 225 pounds, you can increase that weight by like 5 pounds and it won't be much. Whereas an isolation movement like a cable fly, it's pretty hard to progressively overload because you're only lifting like 10 kilos or 20 pounds or whatever. So compound movements and progressive overload should be the biggest focus. But then you can also focus on overloading on all movements. You just overload with weight. And then when that plateaus, you can overload reps, quality of reps, eccentrics, and different things like that. But progressive overload is the biggest key for building your chest and any muscle, that being said. Next is achieving a good pump and volume on isolation movements, okay? So a pump will typically correlate with muscular growth, because what's happening when you're getting a pump is you're breaking down the cells, you're pulling blood, you're pulling nutrients into the muscles, you're wasting it of weight, you're ridding it of waste products, and you're creating the catalyst for muscular growth to occur. So if you're achieving a good pump and you're maximizing the amount of volume and you're training your chest with movements like the cable fly, which are really getting blood in there, and you're doing that quite frequently, then your chest is going to be forced to grow. I recently put up an Instagram post. Follow me on Instagram at Riley J. Byrne. Anyway, but I was talking about the pump and the benefits of it. And Brad Schoenfeld, who's like a genius when it comes to hypertrophy, he says, your cells have to adapt to the extra pressure by reinforcing the strength of their walls, resulting in bigger, stronger, and thicker muscle fibers. So there you go. That's why a pump is so effective. And honestly, it feels amazing too. So yeah, if you want to build a chest, something I've really preached is a lot of cable flies, a lot of isolation movements, which is basically flies for your chest, and just getting a massive pump on that. Next is form, okay? So you can get the best program in the world. I can program for you the greatest amount of rep ranges, volume, progressive overload, linear periodization, etc. But if your form's not good, if you're not executing the movement properly, then nothing's really going to happen. So you have to make sure you're actually contracting with the muscle you want to be contracting with. You have to instigate a solid mind-to-muscle connection. You have to control the eccentric and control the movement, executing with a full range of motion, like you can see in the videos of me working out now. Also, another thing to grow your chest is you've got to hit it from different angles. For example, you see me doing the high cable fly now, then the mid cable fly, then the low cable fly. Also, I do cross body hammer strength chest press, and then normal strength chest press, incline, decline, flat bench press. You want to hit it from all different angles because there's different fibers in the chest. You want to do the landmine press. You want to do everything. And that way you're going to to grow the entirety of your chest. So that's something that's been a major focus for me, is hitting it from different angles, and more specifically executing the movement in a way where I'm recruiting muscular fibers across the entirety of the chest, in particular for pectus, the inner and lower chest, which I think is key to develop to really mask the indentation itself. Next, and one of the biggest things, is frequency, guys. So frequency refers to how often you're training chest. Now, muscle protein synthesis, which is like basically what makes your muscles grow, it's repair and growth of muscular tissue. Anyway, muscular protein synthesis is elevated for like 36 to 48 hours post-workout. So basically after that period, the muscle is not really getting stimulated to grow anymore. So you want the frequency of at least 2 times per week on your chest to make sure you're optimizing the rate of growth, you know? If you're only training it once per week, then that's like 4 days in that week that you haven't trained it, that you could hit it again. So I definitely recommend a frequency of 2 times per week. Like, think about it. If you train for a year training chest and you hit it 2 times per week, then that's 104 sessions in that year versus once per week, which is 52. You're literally going to double your gains. So frequency is a huge thing when it comes to building your chest. And next is consistency, not taking time off and being consistent with training chest. Consistency is the biggest key for anything, guys. Consistency and adherence. So if you can consistently adhere to your routine, to hitting it 2 times per week, to hitting it from different angles, to getting an effective pump, and to prioritizing progressive overload on compound movements at the start, to controlling your eccentric, then that's how you make the gains. It's all about consistency. And my next biggest thing that I can't leave this video without saying is, you can train your chest the most optimal way ever, but if your nutrition is not dialed in, then you're not gonna make gains, guys. It's half in the gym and then it's also half in the kitchen. So you need to be eating in a calorie surplus to warrant muscle gain, and you need to be having enough protein. I recommend anywhere from 2 to 2.6 times body weight in kilos of protein in grams per day. So you need your nutrition to be dialed in as well as your training to optimize your chest growth.
So yeah, guys, that is how you build a big chest. Now, if you found this super informative, then sit back because your day is about to get made. I have provided for you guys a free chest workout in the description that you can download, plus PDF written down my tips for building your chest. So it's gonna be pretty valuable there. So just go to the description box of this to download that. So yeah, that should be really cool and should be informative for you guys. You guys can try that chest workout. Anyway, guys, I'm out of here. Lots of love. Love you all. Hashtag Pectus Warriors. Keep growing. Thanks for following me on this journey. Hopefully you can get that chest looking nice and juicy. And I wish you all the best in your life and on your journey to being the best version of yourselves.